So behind us is the Sea Museum, which we'll go in later. And then to our right is the...
an art museum which has Picasso and Walter's
work. The Mirage Museum, a modern art contemporary art museum. Probably will go there after that car experience the other day. Kind of in front of us is the Monument of Discoveries, which is a monument built in memory of Henry the Navigator.
So many stone people behind us. It's amazing. It's so much detail in it as well.
Yeah, it was built to remember Henry the Navigator, who just discovered.
He discovered.
Discovered stuff. Places. Not space. Not space.
And we are starving. We had some bread yesterday and it's a bit too small, so we had that for breakfast with eggs and mushrooms and onions, and it was delicious. But I really want a chocolate croissant, so we're gonna go get a chocolate croissant, and I can't wait. Yay.
Coffee.
So today is day 16 and we've just walked about 30 minutes from our Airbnb and we're going...
It's called Christ the King, it's basically budget Christ the Redeemer. Jesus.
whatever it's called. Christ the King, woohoo! It's a long ass walk and we made it.
To Sintra, which is only 30 minutes train ride from where we are now.
Which isn't very far, but it's like a national park, so it's pretty much like going to the Lake District, but Portuguese version.
Pretty, and there's loads of castles, which are in the Lake District.
Is there not?
No, there are no castles in the Lake District.
I don't know.
I've never seen one anyway.
I haven't seen one either. But we're going to try and hire bikes so we can be in outdoors and nature and ride our bikes around.
Even though it's raining.
So we've got on the train ready to go to Sintra. The train is going to take about 30 minutes and it cost us €5.50, which is
£4.80.
£4.80 in really pounds, cheap. Which is really cheap to be fair. So it shouldn't take long. We walked about 40 minutes to get here and our backs are sweating so much after it. It was a really hard walk because it's so up and down, but we made it.
They went to McDonald's.
Yeah, we went back to
and they had this really nice garlic potato dip, which is the dive. We don't have that in England.
Afterwards, he looks like a goat. You know, just lick you. You can start licking it like a goat. You do that.
Okay.
And he always goes, don't drink me.
The Pena Palace. It started off in the Middle Ages as a little chapel on top of the massive mountain behind me, but then over time developed into a huge palace where it's hosted many royal events. Behind me there is the Pena Palace. There is the castle of Muros, I think it's in there. And there is one over there as well, a white one on top of that hill, but not quite sure which that one is. But to be honest, the view is kind of ruined by vans and these weird tricycle things keep coming up and taking the tourists up to the top, which is really noisy. Oh well, still beautiful. We just entered Pena Palace and the first thing you notice when you arrive is the mass of people that are here. We didn't expect it to be this popular, but apparently it is. So it cost us, it was meant to cost around €14 to get in, but the queues were humongous. So we decided to just pay online and it was like 5% discount. But it saves us some money.
And we'll go in a lot quicker as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, and there's this little garden behind which is gorgeous to escape massive crowds. And we walk down to a place called the Valley of the Lakes. It's off the beaten track. It takes around 30 minutes from the palace to walk here. So, but the first thing I did when I got here was drop my phone in a stream. I dove for it and really hurt my hand. But luckily, it's waterproof, so no damage done. But look how gorgeous the view is.